Hello. We've been doing a series these past few weeks called Until He Comes. And today I just want to encourage you to hold on to his promises. Until he comes, hold on to his promises. I can remember a time that stands out in my mind was our first trip to India. I didn't plan to go with Larry. I didn't want to go to India, and I didn't even like to leave. I had never left America. But God gave me a promise. And so I remember we were doing a revival at a small Assembly of God church in Norco, California. At the end of the service, everybody was just like fellowshipping and standing around talking. And I remember a man gave a word, and he said, "If you go where I tell you to go, and if you do what I tell you to do, I will go before you, above you, below you, beside you, and behind you." And then he just stopped and he goes, "Well, whatever that was for." And immediately the Holy Spirit said, "That was for you." And so after church that night, I told my husband, I said, "I've changed my mind. I want to go to India with you. I want to go on this trip." And he said, "Okay." He said, "Let's plan on that." And so as we made our plans and we went to India, and I never realized how rough India was in those days, and that was 45 years ago. India can still be pretty rough in some places, but it was pretty rough 45 years ago. And so God had prepared my heart, and God was preparing me that was going to be the first step that I was going to take into international travel, was going into India. And so as we had done that, we went on the trip, and I got so sick, and I had stopped eating, and I was having gallbladder attacks. And finally I told my husband, I said, I said, I'm gonna have to go home. I've gotta go home." And I think that, so I traveled by myself, and back then you had made a lot of stops before you could fly to New York, and that was where I had to get back and go through customs, was New York City. And so I held on to this promise, in Deuteronomy 31:8, that the Lord is the one who goes before you. He will be with you. He will not leave you nor forsake you. Do not fear or be dismayed. So I had that promise, and I was holding on to that promise. And so when I got to New York City, it was insanity. I mean, customs, mercy, it was horrible. I never saw anything like it. People yelling, screaming, pushing, shoving. I mean, it's New York, right? So I stepped over to the side, and I'm watching all this pandemonium. And so this man came up to me, and if you read in Exodus 23:20, it says, "Behold, I'm sending an angel before you to protect you along the way." And this man was as big as Shaq O'Neal, huge, towered over me, and he had an accent, and he towered over me, and he said, "Where are you going?" And I said, "Tulsa, Oklahoma." And he said, "Do you have your tickets?" And I said, "Yes, sir." And he said, "Do you have your passport?" And I said, "Yes." And he said, "Can I have them?" So I gave him my tickets, I gave him my passport, which I would never do today, but I did then 45 years ago. And he said, "Follow me." He walked me straight through customs. And then he took me and set me on a chair, and he said, "I'll be right back." So he left with my passport, my tickets, and then he came back and said, "Follow me." And I followed him, and he took me to a bus and got on the bus and sat beside me, took me to the helicopter transport area that I had to take another helicopter to the other airport to fly to Tulsa, Oklahoma. He stood behind my chair at the helicopter holding area. And then when it was time to board the helicopter, he took me to the helicopter. No one got on the helicopter before me. He sat me in my seat, buckled my seatbelt, and he said, "Everything is going to be okay." He got off the helicopter, and everybody else boarded it, and we took off, and I got back home to Tulsa. But I know that the Lord had sent that man. He had sent an angel, and the angel was there, and he went along the whole way with me, protected me, took care of me. So God was showing me, don't be fearful, don't be dismayed. And today, you might feel like that, but I'm saying, don't be stressed. Don't let that get a hold of you. It's like God goes before his children. You're his child today. He goes before you. And you can rest in that. You can have peace in that you are his child, and that you can trust him. You can trust him to keep his promises. We sing that song Waymaker by Leland, and it says Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. My God, that is who you are. That is who you are. And so I just want to tell you today, until he comes, hold on to his promises. They're true, and he is a promise keeper this morning.